Greetings dear friends, I present to your attention the most common malfunctions and breakdowns that occur on the Hyundai Getz. Hyundai Getz was exclusively front-wheel drive and the design of the drive turned out to be extremely simple, so the choice is only between automatic transmission and 5-speed mechanics, and if the CV joints and drives are quite reliable here, at least up to runs of 200-250,000, then the gearboxes are all with surprises. If you hear that Getz manual transmissions were unsuccessful only before restyling, then do not believe these stories. M5 AF3 boxes are not particularly good on cars of any model year. There are no problems with the design. After all, this is the legacy of Mitsubishi with minimal chances, but the performance is lame. Mainly the bearings fail. The released bearing often begins to hold with runs of a little more than 60,000, and an untimely replacement is fraught not only with the basket pedals and damage to the shutdown fork, but also with damage to the box body. The next in line are the bearings of the input and output shafts. On the bulk of the machines, for only 100,000 run, the bearings of the input shaft are already making noise. The secondary shaft starts to make noise later, but it starts almost inevitably, so if you repair the manual transmission, then you need to change everything. Both the differential and gearbox gear suffer from oil contamination. If you tighten it up with repair, then often there is nothing to repair. A jammed differential will break the body and the main part. The reason for the rapid wear lies not only in the low quality of the original parts, but also in the quality of the oil seals. The box is leaking and the oil level must be monitored both. The owners of cars with 1.6 and 1.4-liter engines were especially unlucky. They have their own boxes, different from boxes with Accent and other Hyundai, so spare parts are in short supply. The only reliable way to repair the box is to overhaul with the installation of new bearings. To reduce the cost of repair, used parts are often used, since the original shafts and gears are not that expensive, 5-8,000 rubles per shaft. But the price of a complete manual transmission bulkhead can easily turn out to be higher than the price of a car. The standard repair option is to install a new shaft with used gears, for example from a more or less live Accent box. Then in case of 1.4 and 1.6-liter engines, everything is assembled into the old box body. Boxes for engines 1.1 and 1.3 liters can be left with the Accent case. Such repairs cost 12-13,000 rubles, which is quite acceptable for the majority. In addition to problems with the manual transmission, there are also troubles with its drive. It initially doesn't please with particular clarity, but with age, the quality of shifting deteriorates due to stretching of the cables, breakdowns of the rocker ball joints of the stage, and simply wear of the ball of the joint. The wear of the axle of the triangular lever, of the longitudinal movements, and the wear of its hinges also greatly affects the clarity of the shifting. In advanced cases, you have to change the lever itself, since it is still supplied as spare parts and costs less than 1,000 rubles. The cables also cause a lot of trouble. Their price is quite high, about 5,000 rubles, but you can get by with a little blood. Basically, the shock-absorbing thrust bushings in the engine compartment wear out. These parts will cost less than 500 rubles, but to replace them, you will have to remove the cables and look for the bushings in the catalogs for Mitsubishi Lancer 9. Part codes 2460A108 and 2460A109. By the way, bearings and synchronizers are also suitable for Mitsubishi manual transmissions, but which ones experts keep at the heart? If you have a glimmer of hope that the automatic transmission is more reliable than mechanics, then I will disappoint you. In principle, the boxes of the KM family of the A4AF3 A4BV2 in series on engines with a volume of 1.3 and 1.4 liters, and boxes of the A4SF1, A4CF2, A4CF1, A4CF2 series with engines of 1.4 and 1.6 liters are considered quite reliable, but in practice closer to 100,000 mileage of the release box until 2008, and especially the boxes of pre-styling cars until 2006, start to be capricious. More recent automatic transmissions run much longer before the first problems appear, at least 180-200,000 kilometers, and individual copies of the boxes can feel quite normal with runs over 300. From a constructive point of view, there are a minimum of shortcomings, and there are obvious weaknesses or not, or they appear with high mileage. But the A4AF3 box was reworked during the transfer of production to Hyundai facilities, and the adjustment of production affected the quality. small reservoirs of solenoids and sensors, overheating due to a weak cooling system and associated oil leaks have a bad effect on the operation of the automatic transmission. It can be assumed that most of the first releases of automatic machines of all series have already undergone medium repairs, at least with weld body repair, and for those who like to drive to the last, the box has undergone a complete overhaul. In addition to the problems associated with the drop in the oil level, oil starvation and weld body malfunctions, there are a number of unpleasant features. For example, a weak differential and blocking linings for the gas turbine engine, which, when driven aggressively, can wear off to the adhesive layer after hundreds of thousands of mileage. And external oil lines have unsuccessful corrosive clamps, which sometimes leads to oil leaks. The older A4AF3, A4BF2 boxes, which are mainly found on cars before 2007, are Mitsubishi's heritage, produced by Hyundai. There are also many problems with the direct clutch drum. It breaks the 046 bushing, especially on pre-styling cars with A4AF3 gearbox, which leads to a serious oil leak, and usually the oil pump is also damaged. With excessively active movement, the overdrive hub bearing breaks down early enough. Typical weld body malfunctions, failure of valves 36, 42, 20, damage to the wiring and speed sensors. Breakdowns of drums unfortunately happen often, and with runs of about 200,000, they will almost certainly manifest themselves even among more or less accurate drivers. The O46 bushings fails less often than the shell drum, but the consequences are much more expensive. The newer automatic transmission A4CF1, A4CF2, which appeared after 2005, began to be widely used on Getz only after 2008. Its early releases, which can be found with a 1.6-liter engine on pre-styling, are a lot of hassle, but the versions after 2008 have particularly no problems in the mechanical part. Damage to the weld body of this box and its electronics are relatively budgetary, although the box is still not particularly durable and trouble-free. Before major repairs with the replacement of the blocking linings of the gas turbine engine, most of the solenoids and revision of the clutches and pump sleeves, on average you can count on 200-250,000 km. The main mechanical problem is the early failure of the oil pump due to poor oil filtration and its rare replacement. Also, the line pressure solenoids fails regularly during operation at a standard oil change interval. The harbinger of its replacement is the blows when the drive and the reverse modes are turned on. It is also worth checking the wiring of the solenoids, which is quite fragile here and is very afraid of vibrations. Change the engine and gearbox mountings in time. A block of shifting solenoids rarely fails completely, but the chances are still far from zero. The price in general is ridiculous, about 10,000 rubles for the entire bed, but if you change them, and if you have already changed the linear solenoids, the wiring is intact, but there are still shocks, then check it at the stand. To improve the operation of this box, it is worth installing an external oil filter. With it, it becomes noticeably more reliable. Buying even a later versions of the A4AF3, A4BF2 automatic transmission is not a good idea. With standard runs for these cars, the box is almost certainly already left and repaired. It is cheap to repair, but the resource until the next repair will be small even with careful maintenance. The budget of the car had almost no effect on the quality of Getz engines. Motors of the G4E series were developed in Mitsubishi, and they have particularly no generic problems. Single overhead cam engines with 12 valve cylinder heads were installed mainly before restyling. G4HG engines with a volume of 1.1 liters and 1.3 liter J4EH engines are rare and mainly on very old cars. After restyling, a 1.4 dual overhead cam engine was added to the engine lineup, which made up a pair of a 1.6 liter engine, 1.6 J4ED and 1.4 J4EE series, respectively. These motors are very reliable. A cast iron block, a timing belt drive, hydraulic lifters, and a fairly massive piston groove give a good margin of safety for any operating style. But the resource is not at all limitless, and due to the design of the piston groove, a small oil appetite is already present closer to 100,000 run. It increases greatly during overheating due to a death of the valve stem seals and leaks in the engine oil seals. In addition, the crankcase ventilation system is unpretentious, which is why the engine constantly sweats. Usually, after 200,000 mileage, the engine comes to a state where it is better to sort it out due to oil consumption. And if you roll another 70,000-60,000, then you will have to make a full-fledged capital with the installation of a repair piston and full restoration of the cylinder head. The belt should be renewed every 60,000 km or even earlier. In cold regions or in stainless steel engines closer to 150-180,000 mileage, it is imperative to replace the chain connecting the camshafts and its dampers. And yet, in the process of operation, many small troubles can arise. And the older the motor, the more trouble. Floating revolution per minute due to a dirty throttle and idle speed regulator on old motors is a common thing. They need to be washed. A dirty intake is also not uncommon. With runs of more than 100,000, you can encounter a knock in the timing due to failures of hydraulic compensators, which are not entirely successful here. For fans of budget repairs, INA compensators from VES stand here. To the credit of the motors, the problem is mainly connected with the rare oil change or its poor quality. With runs of more than 100 to 1,500 km, there are regular failures of coils, high voltage wires, sensors and wiring. Good reviews about reliability usually concern cars with mileage of up to 100, maximum 150,000 km. Further, the motor is still running, but it begins to demand more and more insistent attention. Apparently, the Korean manufacturer didn't particularly count on a greater resource. After about 150,000 mileage, it is worth seriously diagnosing the catalyst. The chances that it will start dusting are quite high, and the engine will not last long after that. The already soft enough piston rings will not tolerate this. By the way, the motor is also very sensitive to the quality of the air filter installation, and its design allows for installer errors. You should not chase singular overhead cam motors. In operation, they are not cheaper than 1.4 and 1.6-liter engines, and the resource of larger engines is generally slightly higher. The difference in the price of repairs is insignificant, as in the difference in the price of the contract unit. On this, information about the problems of Hyundai Getz is exhausted. If you know more or do not agree with what you heard, I am waiting for you in the comments.